The Magic Show is brought to you by StarCityGames.com, and check this out. For each Morningtide booster box or complete set that you pre-order from StarCityGames.com, you'll get one free entry into a drawing for an unlimited Black Lotus. That's right, folks. One lucky customer is going to win an unlimited Black Lotus, and the more Morningtide you pre-order from Star City, the greater your chances of winning. So what are you waiting for? Visit StarCityGames.com and pre-order Morningtide today.
This is Paul Cheon, and welcome to The Magic Show.
Hey, my name's Chris Waltrek, and I work for Star City Games.
Hi, my name is Shaheen Sarani.
What's up? I'm Deshaud Moore.
Hello. My name's Vinny Smith. I write for Star City Games.
I'm Sam Stoddard. I'm the best known for writing the Fearless Magical Inventory article.
Hey, I'm Kenny Mayer.
Hi, I'm Ken Adams.
Hello, I'm Marsh Osri. I live in Raleigh, North Carolina, and I love magic.
I don't really like it. I just feel like there's too much god draws that happen in decks, and it's really hard to beat, like, a god draw from, I mean, even in decks like Tron, if they just throw out their gifts, turn three, it's so hard to beat that. I mean, it seems kind of random to me, some of it, but then again, there are rooms for good plays too, and I think there's a lot of innovations that can be made in deck, so.
I like it. I just lost it turn two Dwarven Blast Miner, but it's a fun format, a lot of different decks, probably like 15, 20 different competitive decks hanging out there.
It's interesting. It's a tough nut to crack. There's so much going on that, I don't know, it's been hard figuring out what the sideboard, but I'm liking it. I'm digging it.
It's basically spread out everywhere. You know, you basically can pick any deck of any, like, you know, control, aggro, combo, and they're all pretty much viable all the time, so it's just what you feel comfortable playing with. And if you think that a particular field is more dominant of, like, aggro, then you play Hyrex, yada yada, etc.
I think it's pretty amazing. I just think somebody needs to find the deck that beats the Dorn deck.
I like it to an extent. What worries me is the whole dredge thing. You know, it's one of those decks where you sort of have to come prepared for it or not prepare for it. I chose to sort of prepare for it, which probably is not the greatest idea. I'm playing Mogmatic in my Affinity deck instead of Control My Script or anything. But I think it's pretty good. You know, there's a lot of decks. It's just a matter of just dodging the hate and playing what you want to play.
Kind of weird. I guess Doran's really good in top two and extended. Doran makes a hard matchup for any deck right now. And Gifts and Given. If Gifts and Given's in any hands, any good control player, Gifts and Given beats you easy. So I don't really know. I like Braids, though.
It's like rock, paper, scissors, except there's five things to throw.
I think it's only okay because no one's breaking it. If this were a Pro Tour format again, I think we would discover that it's horrible. But everyone is having fun today playing whatever they like, so no one's... And that's going to happen at every PTQ, and we're never going to learn how terrible it is, I think, until the very last Grand Prix. So I'm having a blast, and everyone's having a blast, and it's great. But it's only because we're all not as good as we could be.
Well, I'm playing Blue-Eye Tron. Still think Decree of Justice is the best win condition in Extended. I think if you play a solid control deck, you should be all right against, like, Doran decks or any of the aggro builds. You always win the control mirror because you just have way more mana than them. Four Teleria West are like four Jokers in your deck. You always have Tron, turn five, turn six at the latest. And Mindsliver Lock is just such a powerful card because you have a land that's half your combo piece, and then Mindsliver by itself is good. So it's a really, really easy combo to get going.
I'm playing Blue-Black Braids League. It's like a Psycho Talk deck with Braids in it. Runs Force Spike, Spell Snare, Reman, Smother, Ghastly Demise, and Explosives.
I'm playing Affinity. I'm a big fan of the deck. I've played it for a while. One of the few decks I could actually build online without paying, you know, $500,000. So I've been playing it a lot, testing it a lot online. It's really fast. If people aren't prepared for it, you're just going to crush them. If they are prepared for it, you still have game because, you know, I can kill on turn three with Fatal Frenzy. So
I'm playing a horrible deck. I'm playing, it's sort of like Balancing Kings. If you've seen the Scepter Boom list, it's kind of like that, except I just took out the Boom Bust because I thought they were awful. I still run Scepter, Chant, Helix, and I'm also running four Erratic Explosions and three Dracos. Because, you know, Draco's not that bad. It's a 6-mana 9/9 creature. I mean, sometimes you just hop into it and win. Or even if people are 10 life, sometimes it's a Helix end of turn into a Erratic Explosion, your Gargadon that you topped up, is enough to win games. It's been fairly consistent for me.
I'm playing the Doran deck that I played at the Winter King event. I don't really have a good reason for playing it. I got lists from three different people that I trust, and I had to decide between three of them. I ended up going with Luis again, and I'm okay with it. I think I can beat anything in the room.
I'm playing the Doran Rock deck because the field's open completely, and it's got a good matchup versus everything.
I'm playing a Doran deck, which was my safe deck because I chickened out and didn't want to play my Intruder Alarm opposition deck, which my buddy is playing, and I think he's doing better than me now. But
the Doran deck, everyone.
The Doran PT Junk deck.
I've seen a whole bunch of rock variants, like black, white, green, and just regular black, green, or Profane Command, and Eternal Witness, High Arc. I don't know, it's a whole bunch of black, green, white.
There's a couple of Doran decks. I guess that's still the most played, but not as much as I thought. And I see a lot of Tron decks also.
It seems like the biggest deck has been the four-color blue decks, or the other Trinket Mage-based counterbalance top decks. That's been the one deck I've seen a lot of. The other one I've seen a lot of is the Doran decks, the sort of the aggressive Doran decks with Confidant and Treetops and a lot of removal.
I think right now I'd say everyone's playing Affinity with the Springleaf Drums with new Fatal Frenzies in it too.
Well, everyone's playing my deck too, and I think they're playing it for bad reasons. Everyone thinks the deck is a mopey, rockish control deck when that's just a blatant lie. It's actually a beatdown deck that happens to have cards that make it look like a rock deck. So I think everyone is just completely misguided, but they're still playing the deck anyway. And, you know, if somebody doesn't test a lot, they're going to start the tournament and have no idea what their deck is, and that makes me sad. But, and the other issue is that it's actually really hard to play the mirror badly. So I'm worried about other people in the mirror just outdrawing me.
Everyone's playing the Doran Rock deck, and I've played two mirror matches so far, and it's the worst. So
I'm showing Monday, I was hoping someday. I have not seen a lot of Tron yet, and I think I've only seen two Dredge decks.
Everyone's not playing Ikrit, which is good because the Doran deck actually is horrible versus that deck completely. Can't really win at all, even with Ley Lines. So it's probably a waste of slots. But also no one's playing, I saw one Balancing Act deck, and that's extremely powerful. I think that's probably one of the best decks.
I actually haven't seen anybody playing Scepter Chant anymore. I haven't seen nobody playing Scepter Chant. I've seen that Scepter Boom deck that did good a couple weeks ago, but other than that, I haven't really seen anything.
No one's playing Aggro Loam, and no one's playing Heartbeat very much.
I don't see many Ideal. There's only a few Smattering of Tron players. There's a decent amount of red decks, but that's because this is Roanoke down here, where Five Color Zoo was everywhere last season, so I kind of expected it.
Probably Mono Blue. It's gaining a little bit of popularity, but I think it should be more popular than it is. There's also the next level blue deck, Chapin's deck, that I haven't done very much testing against it, but that seems pretty good too.
Surprisingly, I don't see any combo at all. I mean, last season you saw a lot of Heartbeat. I mean, I don't know if the season's changed so much. You see Heartbeat, you see Tendril's Desire, Balancing Act. I mean, a lot of different combo decks, so I was expecting to see some more of that.
I think no matter what happens or how good a deck is, there are not going to be enough people playing it for what it should be. And that's just the nature of Magic, because everyone wants to have fun, and that's what this game is for, and there are very few people like me who are out here just to crush everyone, so.
Greater Gargadon. It's my favorite card of all time.
My favorite card in Extended is Dark Confidant.
Decree of Justice.
Give some giving. This card's always fun to play.
I locked it on Hierarch. I think Engineered Explosives is currently my favorite card because it's good against everything. The mana is so good that you can play five colors easily, and you know, five mana blows up just about anything. You get Academy of Ruins, you can recurse it. Yeah, I think that's the best card right now in Extended.
I think Profane Command, because I totally didn't expect that it would be good at all or even playable, and it's just ridiculous. Like Zach Hill and I were talking about this stuff before the Pro Tour and after the Pro Tour, and we were just constantly like, okay, well, this format is stupid. Games are going to be over by turn four. It's going to be horrible. I get to the Pro Tour with that in mind, and then I get crushed in by people who are just playing 10 turn games, and they're planning on that, and I wasn't, so once we hit turn 5 or 6, I was like, oh, well, you're still playing, this isn't good. And that's how everything is, so Profane Command is actually just the best ever.
Warm Shin or Smother. I feel both of those cards are really good right now.
My German Duresses. Just because, you know, it's fun to say, I zwang you.
Hi, my name's Martin Bowers, and this is my first PTQ. Well, my son plays Magic. I'm twice the age of most of the guys here, and he needed someone to play with because a lot of his playing buddies were getting out of it or moving away or something. So he said, hey, Dad, let me teach you to play this game so I'll have someone to play with. So he's been teaching me. I've been playing for about 2 months, and here I am. It's pretty complex. I mean, this extended tournament, there's like 5,500 cards and over 5,000 of them I've never seen before. So that makes it a little tough. There's a lot of subtleties. I mean, there's just the complexities of how you play. It's been fun, but it's quite complex. Well, definitely you need to find some other players who can show you the game. That's the most helpful. I also looked at a lot of information online. I thought there were some videos by Wizards of the Coast about very basics of the game that were useful. Reading the rules, downloading them online is good. But I think the main thing is you need to find some friends who know how to play, who can teach you a lot of the subtleties. That's the only way you'll learn them. My son told me, he says, this is what you need to do, Dad. He says, look at the Valencia Day 2 deck list, those that advance to Day 2. Find a deck you like, play around with that. The guys and I can help you tweak it and give you some pointers. And so I picked, it's a red deck wins, aggro with a lot of burn. So I thought, this is fun to play. And it seems simpler than the control deck, seemed too many decisions. So I said, aggro deck's probably easier for me as a beginner. And so that's what I brought. Right now at this moment, I'm 4-3. Not too bad for my first tournament ever. It's been fun. I've made a few mistakes, but I've learned quite a few things, and everyone I've played with has been very nice. Everyone's ashamed. Well, we all just... I'm still going to keep playing. There's another tournament coming up next month that's not too far from home, so I'm certainly going to play in that. And I'm still learning the game, and it's fun.
I think Lorwyn, it has a peek in the future. Meaning, here's a card that I think really we succeeded in white that I think we can learn from, which is...
It's pretty interesting looking at how many cards had to be changed. The Kulfiner's plans used to be...
Like, Garrick, we definitely pushed the Green Planeswalker. That was on purpose. Part of it was kind of accidental. I mean, we did not know...
Most people are here because they want to play Magic, and you know, that's cool, but I'm here to crush everybody, so.
Star City is the place to be.